Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. In the Markandeya Purana, there is a very beautiful section spanning about 700 verses, which is also referred to as Devi Saptashati or Chandi Path. So what are these 700 verses about? They are the different episodes when Devi manifested in different forms and defeated Adharma in the form of certain asuras. In the fifth chapter of this Devi Saptashati, there is a very, very beautiful section called Aparajita Stuti. And I want to talk a little bit more about this. But before that, we want to understand the nature of the human problem. The moment I see myself and the other, I have to deal with the other. The other can be my mother-in-law. The other can be a mosquito. The other can be the person I like. The other can be a quality in me. Whatever the other is, I want to be in harmony with the other. When I do not experience harmony, I experience conflict. When I am in conflict, I want to get rid of it. I don't want it. And so the human struggle of dealing with the other. This Devi Mahatmyam helps us to change our relationship with the other. When I'm saying the other, I mean the Jagat, the world, and I also mean Devi or Goddess. Devi Mahatmyam and this particular section helps us see that what I consider as the Jagat, the world, is indeed nothing else but Ishvara, but Devi. What I see as the world is nothing else but the very manifestation of Devi. In other words, Jagat Darshanam, seeing the Jagat clearly, is Devi Darshanam. Seeing the Jagat is seeing the Devi. And seeing myself, Atma Darshanam, is indeed Devi Darshanam. That seeing the world directly, clearly, is seeing Devi. I don't need another vision to prove to me that Devi exists, because the world is right here, her manifestation is right here. And so in my appreciation, in my understanding of this world, all that I see is Devi in her many, many forms. And that is the beauty of this Aparajita Stuti, which occurs in the fifth chapter of Devi Saptashati. None other than the Devas start to talk about and appreciate the glory of the Devi. And so we have a set of more than 20 verses which are talking about the manifestation of the Devi in many forms. It's just a sampling of the many forms that she has. But what is very beautiful about these shlokas is you also are able to see that seeing the Devi is seeing yourself. that seeing the many forms of the Devi as qualities in you, as qualities such as Daya, Shanti. Daya is generosity, Shanti is peace and absence of conflict, Tushti, satisfaction, contentment, that this very quality that exists in you is a manifestation of the Devi. And this quality is something that exists in you, it exists in all beings, sarvabhuteshu. And so what about it? Well, this quality helps you to deal with adharma, with what is not right. In other words, you become an embodiment of dharma as you are able to see that the Devi manifests in you. There is a very beautiful word in Sanskrit called namaha. Namaha meaning na mama iti. It's not mine. Namaha, which also we will translate as my namaskara, my salutations, is really reflecting my understanding that this is not mine. So when I say namo devyai namo namaha, my namaskara to Devi, that all that I see, all that I am, is really not me, that all that is here is the Devi. And in saying namaha, I indicate my understanding of the same. Very beautiful. So the whole Aparajita Stuti starts with 4 or 5 verses which talk about how I see Devi.
Namo Devyai Mahadevyai Shivayai Satatam Namaha Namah Prakrityai Bhadrayai Niyatav Pranatasmatam Raudrayai Namo Nityayai Gauryai Dhatryai Namo Namaha Jyotsnyayai Chendurupinyai Sukhayai Satatam Namaha Kalyanyai Pranatavrityai Siddhyai Kurmo Namo Namaha Nairityai Bhubritam Lakshmyai Sharvanyai Te Namo Namaha Durgayai Durgaparayai Sarayai Sarvakarinyai Khyatyai Tathaiva Krishnayai Bhumrayai Satatam Namaha Atisamyati Raudrayai Natastasyai Namo Namaha Namo Jagat Pratishthayai Devyai Krityai Namo Namaha.
In other words, I see Devi as the very intelligence that pervades this entire world. I see Devi as the one who provides, who indeed is the material for this entire world. I see Devi as the one who is always with Shiva, the auspicious one. In other words, I see her as Shakti. I see her as Raudra. My namaskara to Durga, who helps in crossing over the many obstacles that I face. At the same time, I see her as the cause of all causes. So as you see these words, you also see the meaning of these words. And as you see the meaning, your vision is transformed. Because in your vision, Jagat Darshanam is Devi Darshanam. Devi Darshanam is Atma Darshanam. Seeing the Jagat is seeing Devi. Seeing Devi is seeing yourself. It is a very beautiful equation which emerges in this stuti. And then you will see a lot of verses which say, Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu, this Devi which abides in sarvabhutaha. So bhuta doesn't mean ghost, okay? In some of the Indian languages, bhut means ghost. In Sanskritam, bhutaha means a being. So sarvabhuteshu, in all beings, without an exception, Devi abides, Devi is. And few qualities are being mentioned. So the first one, Yadevi sarvabhuteshu chetana. Chetana iti abhidhiyate. Chetana meaning consciousness. That which exists, that which always is, that which is the basis of all names, all forms, whatever be the form. It may be a mosquito, it may be an amoeba, it may be a lizard, it may be a human being, it may be a very beautiful person, it may be a very ugly person, it may be devatas themselves. That which abides in all beings is Devi. In what form does she abide? Well, she abides as Chetana, as consciousness. That which doesn't have a form, that which is not a property of that being, that which is the very basis of that being. And so what about it? Well, in my understanding, Namastasyai Namastasyai, my Namaha, my Namaskara to this Devi who abides in all beings as consciousness. And so in just stating this shloka, what has happened is my vision undergoes a transformation. My vision is no longer I and the other, because now what is it I see? I see that all that is here is Devi, that all that is here is consciousness. And that consciousness, what is that consciousness? It is Devi. Is it available only in one or two spiritual people, religious people? No. Sarva bhuteshu, without an exception, sarva, all, everyone, she abides. And so my recognition of this, which makes me see that Jagat darshanam is Devi darshanam. Then we look at some of the shlokas and we see the meaning. As you go through the shlokas, you will find words that are referring to certain qualities in you. And you will also find words that are revealing the swarupa, the very nature of Devi. And you will find some words that are referring to the processes that occur in this body, which sustain this body, which nurture this body, which in fact contribute and are the very prana of this body. So some of those words are referring to hunger and thirst.
Ya Devi sarva bhuteshu Vishnu mayeti shabdita namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
She is indeed that power, that shakti, that Vishnu maya, which is the basis of all creation, all manifestation. And to that Devi, my namaskara.
Ya Devi sarva bhuteshu chetanetyabhidhiyate namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
How does Devi abide in all beings? As chetana, as consciousness. And here when we say chetana, the being could be a lizard, it could be an amoeba, it could be Brahmaji, it could be a human being. That consciousness which doesn't have a form, which is not a property of that being, that consciousness that abides in all beings without an exception, that Chetana Devi is. And so my namaskara to Devi.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu buddhirupena samstita namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
Buddhi, the intelligence to make choices, to basically live our life, the intelligence to make a safety pin, or the intelligence to make a spaceship. Intelligence exists in all beings, and of course the extent to which we tap into it reveals how our lives turn out. So to the buddhi that exists in me, to the intelligence and intellect that exists in me and that exists in others, I see the laws and principles that make it function, and that indeed is Devi.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu nidra rupena samstita namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
Nidra. Nidra means sleep. Very important function for all beings, because that is how you rest, you recoup, and the body of course is very active during sleep because it is getting ready for a new day. And from rest emerges all activity. So this blessing of sleep that everyone is endowed with, where you experience samadhi, and the samadhi of course, but you experience a resolution of yourself, the subject and the object. That in sleep there is no conflict. You may be a king, you may be a beggar, it doesn't matter. That nidra, we call it Nidra Devi also. So to that nidra, my namaskara.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu kshudharupena samstita namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
What is it that sustains the prana of the sharira, the life of the person in terms of the body? It is indeed food. And if it were not for hunger, one would not eat. So to that very drive, to that very desire for food, to that hunger, shudha, my namaskara.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu chaya rupena samstita namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
Here chaya can be taken as shadow, in the sense of wherever there is light there is shadow, or the jiva, the individual, can be taken as chaya, as a reflection of Brahman, of Devi, the reality.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu shakti rupena samstita namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
Another very beautiful word, shakti. Shakti is the power to get things done. And we are all endowed with three shaktis at every given moment. Ichha shakti, the power to desire. Kriya shakti, the power to do. And jnana shakti, the power to know. The little ant that wants a crumb of the cookie has a desire, ichha shakti, for it. Maybe wants to take it to the ant hill. The ant also knows how to get to that crumb. So there is jnana shakti. If the cookie crumb is very big in size, the ant knows I have to collaborate with another ant so that I can take this crumb back. There is definitely Jnana Shakti. And of course, the ant acts on it, gathers two or three of them, and they carry that cookie crumb to wherever they want. There is Kriya Shakti. A little ant is endowed with all three Shaktis: Ichha Shakti, Kriya Shakti, and Jnana Shakti. What do you think about human beings? Of course, every moment we have these three Shaktis. So of course it all depends on how we use it. And here this beautiful shloka is pointing us in that direction and telling us that Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Shakti Rupena Samstita, that I exist as your very Shakti. All the Shakti that you have in this world, it is me. And so Devi Darshanam is Atma Darshanam.
Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Trishna Rupena Samstita Namastasyai Navastasyai Namastasyai Namo Namaha. Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Kshanti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai Navastasyai Namastasyai Namo Namaha.
Then words such as Trishna and Kshanti. Trishna meaning thirst and Kshanti meaning a sense of accommodation. So thirst, again being a physiological function, it contributes to sustenance of life. I'm talking from the standpoint of the body. And Kshanti, a sense of accommodating people, situations, just like space does. Space Akashaha accommodates all elements and elementals. There is no preference, there is no partiality. It just accommodates. That's the very quality. And we grow when we accommodate. We accommodate, we make space for people and situations. This doesn't mean that we accommodate adharma. This is very important. In the name of accommodation, you cannot accommodate adharma. But you can certainly accommodate people and situations that are not in line with your raga and dveshas, with your cravings and aversions. Because we have a long rule book. How people should be, how people shouldn't be, how even gurus should be and gurus shouldn't be. And so we tend to reject a lot of people and a lot of situations. And so this very beautiful quality of accommodation, that indeed is a manifestation of Devi. And my namaskara to that quality.
Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Jati Rupena Samstita Namastasyai Navastasyai Namastasyai Namo Namaha.
Jati. Jati is a group, and there are all kinds of groups depending on the way we classify or characterize them. So that Devi which is in the form of all jatis, all kinds of groupings, whatever groupings we may have, to that collective sense of a group, my namaskara, because indeed she is Devi.
Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Lajja Rupena Samstita Namastasyai Navastasyai Namastasyai Namo Namaha.
Lajja. Lajja is not really shame. Lajja is a sense of modesty, you know, a sense of being conscious of yourself and your surroundings. Suppose if I ask someone, can you speak? The person may just sort of straighten up, clear the throat. There is a sense of modesty in the sense that there might be a little hesitation to speak, which is indicating that you want to do the right thing. You may be hesitant, you may be a bit modest about it, but that indeed will help you learn.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Shanti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha.
Shanti, which is peace or an absence of conflict, that when I am in harmony with the other could be my partner or my child, or it could be the political system. When I am in harmony, I see what is, and that shanti that I experience in me, amongst me and the other, that shanti is indeed Devi, and my namaskara to Devi.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Shraddha Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha.
Shraddha. Shraddha is a trust. It is a trust in the words of the Shastra. It is a trust in the words of the Guru, because the Guru speaks nothing else but the Shastra. And that Shraddha, which is trust, is what really delivers the goods for you as a Vedanta student, or really as a spiritual seeker. You trust the laws and principles, you trust that Devi abides in it. Trust is not blind belief. Trust comes from your understanding that nothing is opposed to you. In fact, everything is an ally, is a support for you and your life's journey. And to that Shraddha, that really blossoms in you if you learn to cultivate trust. To that Shraddha, my namaskara.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Kanti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha.
Kanti, which is beauty, any kind of sense of being very lovely, very beautiful, to the beauty that exists in all beings, because every being is very, very beautiful. As they say, beauty lies in the eyes of the beholder, and as the beholder, if you are able to see that all that is here is Devi, then you stand transformed. It's not about the other. It's your vision that is transformed. And to that beauty that you see in everyone, my namaskara.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Lakshmi Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha.
Lakshmi, very beautiful word, standing for all forms of wealth. And in this beautiful culture, we worship Lakshmi, because she is the source of all wealth, all resources, because resources have a power only in the sense of getting things done. They cannot really contribute to your power as a person, although we think so. Lakshmi gets things done, creates positive change in the lives of people. And to that Lakshmi, which is indeed a manifestation of Devi, my namaskara.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Vritti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha.
Vrittihi. Vrittihi is a thought, a flow of thought. It can also refer to activity. So any activity you do, eating, sleeping, drinking, dancing, reading, singing, etc., etc., whatever activity you do, vrittihi, Devi manifests as that very activity itself. And to that activity, my namaskara.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Smriti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha.
Smriti, which is the capacity to remember or memory, the sheer capacity to remember important things and not so important things, that power is indeed Devi. So luckily for us, even if you're a chef, you won't really remember the many breakfasts and lunches and dinners you've had all the years of your life. That's the power of memory, that within that is a capacity to forget certain things and a capacity to remember all that is relevant to you in your life. That in that capacity indeed, that power is Devi.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu daya rupena samstita namastasyai navastasyai namastasyai namo namaha.
Daya meaning kindness, something that is in very short supply these days. When you see the other person, you really see the other person, you can't help but be kind. Not because you're making an effort to be kind, because you see that that person is you. Even if you don't see that person as you, we've all been given the capacity to understand what the other is going through, although I need not go through that. And that understanding really transforms into kindness. And to that kindness which sustains society, that kindness which allows all of us to reach out to each other, that very quality is indeed the manifestation of Devi, and so my namaskar to that.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu tushti rupena samstita namastasyai navastasyai namastasyai namo namaha.
Tushti. Tushti is a sense of satisfaction, a sense of contentment that I have enough, I am enough. The moments in our lives when we experience that, when we see that very clearly, that is the blessing of Devi, and my namaskara to Devi.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu matra rupena samstita namastasyai navastasyai namastasyai namo namaha.
Matra, mother. The mother just knows how to embrace her child and to be for the child all that the child needs, all that the child wants. No conditions attached. That's our experience, at least in the initial days. So how about having a mother who is unconditional in her support, in her acceptance of you, in all that she does for you? Well, that indeed is Devi. So in the very form of mother who is there for you, whether you acknowledge her, you insult her, you humiliate her, you ignore her, but she's always there for you in the way in which you want, and to that mother my namaskara.
Ya Devi sarvabhuteshu bhranti rupena samstita namastasyai navastasyai namastasyai namo namaha.
Bhranti. Bhranti is an error in thinking. It's a sort of a delusion. And this error in thinking is a very beautiful thing. Why? Because confusion is the only way to clarity. There's no other way. Okay? So if people are not confused, then I get a bit concerned. Because then you're just taking things at face value. So confusion is a very good sign. In fact, if you have some doubts about who you are as a person, what is this world about? If you're not quite sure, then that indeed is what will bring you to self-inquiry. That indeed is what will bring you to Devi. That indeed is what will bring you to Vedanta and the understanding of the absolute reality that you are. So to that bhranti, to that error in thinking, to that delusion, my namaskara.
Indriyanam adhishtatri bhutanam chakileshuya bhuteshu satatantasyai Vyapti Devyai Namo Namaha.
And then this entire section concludes by saying that Devi governs all the faculties, Indriyanam, Adhishtatri. She is the very locus of the way in which all the sense organs operate. In other words, how we see the world, how we perceive the world, how we interact with the world, all of that is really a manifestation of the power and the glory of Devi.
Jiti rupena ya kritsnam etat vyapyasita jagat namastasyai 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 namo namaha namastasyai 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 namo namaha.
And that exists in all things, all beings. There is a word used, Vyapti Devyai, that there is no place where Devi is not, there is no moment when Devi is not. That all that is here is Devi. She pervades all beings, she pervades all moments, and she pervades this entire Kritsnam Jagat, this world. How? As Chitti. Chitti is consciousness, the very basis of all names, all forms. And to that Devi, to that goddess, to that being, which is my being, my namaskara. Namastasyai 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 namo namaha. That my recognition of Devi pervading this entire Jagat, my recognition of Devi pervading all my functions of the body and the mind, my recognition of Devi pervading all the very beautiful qualities in me and in other beings, that recognition is what transforms my reality. It transforms my reality because it is the reality. Earlier I thought I was different from the world. Now, in recognition of the meaning of these shlokas, I see that I and the world and all that exists and all that abides is indeed Devi. So all that is here is Devi in the form of me, the world, and Devi. Or I may say, all that is here is Devi. I am incidental, the world is incidental, meaning it is not intrinsic, it is incidental. I am incidental, the world is incidental. That's it. And so you live, you abide in this understanding that all that is here is sacred, and all the beings that are there, they are indeed a manifestation of Devi. And so where is the scope for conflict? Where is the scope for me to put down or humiliate the other? Where is the scope for me to fight the other to prove that I am superior or you are inferior? By reciting these very beautiful shlokas, we can appreciate that Devi exists and abides in me and all beings. I conclude, Ya Devi Sarvabhuteshu Shakti Rupena Samstita Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha Namastasyai 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 Namo Namaha. May I invoke all the grace, all the blessings of Devi to manifest fully in my life, for me to discover that she indeed is manifest fully in my life, to to live a life of dharma, to live a life that upholds universal values and ethics, which allow the society to be sustained. May I discover the shakti I have to deal with adharma. Adharma comes in many, many forms, and adharma can reflect in the small act of corruption. It can be in the way I talk to my family members. It can be trying to use your time in the office for personal work. There are different moments in my life that I display adharma. Before we worry about how others are not upholding their dharma, may I turn my attention to myself and try and live a life of dharma, and every action can be a puja to her. I may or may not go to the temple, although I recommend that everyone goes to the temple, but still, every act of mine can be a puja to Devi, because I recognize her manifestations in this Jagat. In fact, I see the Jagat is indeed Devi. So all the time I am not relating to the other. The other I am relating to is Devi. And in relating to Devi, I see that I am not different from her. That all that is here is me. All that is here is Devi. Om Tat Sat.